Hello, everybody. My name is Michael Wood. I am the head designer at Captivata Multimedia and the lead instructor at the Alpha Academy. That's the Academy of Literature, Publishing, History, and Writing. Check us out if you want to learn more about online courses and how to get your message out, become a great storyteller and multimedia expert. In this tutorial, I will be discussing the brand new, as of today's date, which is December 11, 2018, the brand new Ascend by Wix. What is it exactly? We're going to talk about this in this episode. If you are a small business or an entrepreneur, you definitely should be listening to this. Or if you are a web designer and you make websites for your small business or entrepreneur clients, then once again, you'll want to know what Ascend is and how you should be offering it to your clients. So if you want to check this out, stay tuned. Once again, I'm Michael Wood, the head designer at Captivata Multimedia. Let's talk about what this Ascend by Wix is. It is basically a packaging of many of the services that they have been providing within the last couple of years. Now, they've added sort of, here and there, brick by brick, small pieces to help small businesses, things like emails, shoutouts, managing your contact list, just different plugins on the Wix back end. But what they've done now is they've packaged them all together into sort of a build your business toolkit that they are calling Ascend. Now, this is not a brand, this is not a brand new service. It's rather a reorganizing of many of the services they have been providing in the past. Now, they may in the future choose to package these services as Ascend cloud-based services and maybe charge a premium for it. I haven't seen any pricing or anything like that at this time. You could always go to Wix.com, follow their blog, and see if there's more information on the future of what they call Ascend. So what is it currently? Well, there's three parts to it, and you see the three parts up here in the menu. So there's the part where you're going to connect, and then connect with your site visitors. Then there's a way to manage those connections. And then there's a way for you to promote and grow your services. So those are the distinct sort of tools that are in the toolbox. So under Connect and Manage, you have a variety of tools here. One of them being a chat. So building in a live chat, you can instantly answer questions. And live chat is actually one of the biggest sort of client and lead generating techniques that are out there. People like to talk to people and not robots. And so the more human you can make your website, that's generally going to lead into more conversions. And so that's what chat is all about. And then they have their forms where you can create custom forms such as surveys or quizzes. And that helps to engage your audience. You can gather leads. So this will be huge the way you use it. You can practically build your own marketing funnel using Wix. I wouldn't exactly compare this to ClickFunnels or other services like that, where they build websites exclusively for the funnel. However, you can build sort of mini funnels using the different forms that are available to you. And let's just talk again about forms. Forms has been around with Wix for a long time. It's come in many various designs. In some ways, it was just provided as a third party through 123 Contact. And you had to pay 123 Contact for premium services on forms. Now, forms seems to be more of an integrated solution and part of this whole package called Ascend. Of course, you have an inbox. So if you manage sort of your email that comes in, all of your communications, all your messages that come in through your forms are all going to be in a unified inbox. There is a contact manager where you can actually add things like notes and labels. So that as you start to build your leads up to, let's say, in the thousands or tens of thousands, those notes and labels will enable you to filter those leads pretty quickly. And there's sort of an automated way they can do it. A lot of the ways you see MailChimp and other types of email services do, where you can label, hey, anybody who signed interest in this event, let's label them. And then you could filter those people and retarget them because they were obviously interested in one event. Maybe they came, maybe they didn't, but you'll be able to retarget your marketing campaign to those people. This really, in the hands of a great marketer, is a very handy tool. The next thing is automations. Now, this is interesting. Again, we're getting sort of into that ClickFunnels, MailChimp territory where we can set up triggered actions which will automate an email sequence. So very interesting to see how this plays out. You have members, so if you want, you can actually have a login to your website. So people can decide to join, they fill out a form that you create, and then you can make them a member, which means they have a username and password. Now this opens up a whole lot of opportunities because as sort of this virtual wall that you could build into your site, separating the casual visitor from the members, you can then make exclusive content just for members. And it's another great way of gathering leads and keeping loyalty with your clients and site visitors. You could set up price quotes, really good if you're a service and you provide free quotes, such as building websites or let's say cleaning houses. You can now invoice your clients, your visitors, and you can keep track of those invoices. This is, again, really good if you are a service-oriented business. You can establish workflows. So, again, this goes into projects, sales funnels. You can collaborate with your team. You could stay on top of your workload. You can add collaborators. So this is really good if your website is really representing a small business where you have a team of people. You might have someone who's good with advertising, someone who's good with customer service. You can create a workflow and provide limited access to those different stations and specialties. So really can add a very rich team-based approach to your website. And you can add tasks and reminders. It's kind of a to-do list that they add. So that's how you connect with people, and that's how you can manage those contacts, and you can accept payments. Let's go now into the next stage. So the next thing you want to do is promote and grow. So this is your marketing area, and this is good for your SEO. One of the things is an SEO wizard. And what that's going to do, it's going to scan your website and show you where all the shortcomings might be and will help you fix those search engine optimizations. Like maybe you don't have an H2 header on your site. This will help you get set up with that. Another thing is email marketing, shoutouts. Now I know for a fact there are a limited number of shoutouts you can make to a limited number of emails. You can increase those numbers through paid premium services. And that might be the main driver of people upgrading their Ascend type of services. You can also manage your social posts. It says right here, reach out to your audience on social media. So you can basically build templates and then get those posted on all the different social media platforms. I haven't really played with that a whole lot. It's a little new to me here. Of course, you can do videos to show off your business. You can share those videos on Facebook and YouTube. So there's a video maker. Again, that's something I would need to explore a little further. And then there are marketing integrations. So you can connect things like Google Analytics or connect your Facebook pixel to your site. And that's going to enable you to know who's visiting your site. What pages are they looking at? What browsers are they using? What mobile device are they using to access your site? And that's really going to help you make wise decisions when it comes to the design of your site. For example, if you go and look at your Google Analytics, and it looks like more than 75% of your visitors are using their mobile device, then you're going to need to put your energy into the mobile version of your site to make sure that it looks pristine, perfect, everything's in the right place. And then you can manage coupons for specific products and services that you might provide. So there's a whole lot of tools. Once again, all of these were sort of available in the past. They just weren't packaged the way they are now, which is why it is called Ascend by Wix. So if I were to say, hey, I want to get started, it's going to go to your Wix account and ask you to select one of your sites. In this case, I will select my alpha writing site here. And it's going to open up my dashboard. So the dashboard is where a lot of these Ascend components are being built. So you have an inbox, you have a contact list. And if you're just starting out, you could upload a lot of these contacts directly into your marketing platform. You can manage your form submissions. This place will help you manage your price quotes. You can also manage your invoices right here. You can create new invoices, set those up, and they can pay you online, which is pretty nice. And you can set up some task reminders, and then they have automations. And this is where we get a little bit into your sales marketing funnel type of stuff, where you can basically set up an automated sequence. So let's say somebody decides to become a member. You're going to use this automation and send them either one email or a series of emails over the course of a few days to help onboard them to your product, service, or website. So that is pretty much what Ascend is. It's a Kickstarter. It's an all-in-one business solution brought to you by Wix, just sort of collecting everything together and appearing on a dashboard. If you have any questions or comments about Ascend, or you find that you're using Ascend, let me know. And if you're a web designer, I did say in the beginning of this video, I would tell you how to pitch this to your business. So what you can really do is set up two tiers of web design services. You can set up just the website. You know, just building a website is service enough, and sometimes you can just hand that over to the client, let them manage the site, they pay you for the design. But now, this is going to leverage you as a web designer, because you can then, let's say, charge a monthly fee in order for you to enable these small business tools. And in the past, they probably had to use a lot of third-party solutions, such as MailChimp and ClickFunnels and 123 contact forms and all these other sort of third-party services to do all of these things. And then they have to manage all of those separate accounts. People love the simplicity of having everything in one place, and now you can offer that to small businesses. Hey, you know what? We're going into 2019. Websites are way beyond just looking at a glorified business card where here we are, here's where we're located, give us a call. It goes much further than that. if your website is not generating leads and creating an email list, it's really not doing the work it needs to be doing for you. So if you want to learn more about building websites from concept to automation, I go into much more detail with each of these components in my web design course. You can find us on Udemy, Skillshare, or at the Academy of Literature, Publishing, History, and Writing. Get 30 days for free. Don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for being with me, guys. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.